In the previous video, Understanding the Importance of Proper Grounding, I explained that connecting a data acquisition system to earth ground helps protect people and equipment, provides a reference point for voltage signals, and can reduce unwanted electrical noise from electromagnetic interference and radio frequency interference. In this video, I will discuss how to make that connection. Before proceeding with any installation, please read, understand, and comply with the safety instructions found in Campbell Scientific Data Logger and Power Supply manuals. Earth grounding, also known as earthing, means creating a conductive connection between an electrical circuit and the earth. This is both a physical and electrical connection to a location near the data acquisition system, but apart from it. To make this connection, I will need one or more grounding rods. These are typically made of copper or copper-clad steel and are driven vertically into the ground to establish a connection with the earth. Grounding conductors. These are heavy gauge wires that establish electrical connections between the earth and the equipment. Grounding rod clamp. This securely connects the grounding conductor to the grounding rod. Campbell Scientific ships these items with instrumentation tripods and 10-foot towers. They are available in a kit, part number UTGND, for 20-foot and 30-foot towers. They may also be purchased as the QST6 grounding kit for applications where a lightning rod is not used. These grounding kits are sufficient for many applications. If my installation site requires additional grounding equipment, such as a longer grounding rod, I will purchase that locally. Site assessment and methods for improving grounding will be discussed later in this video. The goal of the grounding system is to have 5 to 25 ohms or less of resistance between the data logger ground lug and the earth. Starting at the point where the grounding rod is in the soil, the low resistance pathway is as follows. The grounding rod is electrically in contact with the earth. The grounding rod clamp bonds 4-gauge wire to the grounding rod. Best practice is to attach the grounding rod clamp before pounding the rod into the ground. This is because the top of the grounding rod may be deformed during installation, making it difficult to slide the clamp over the rod. The other end of the 4-gauge wire connects to the external ground lug on the weatherproof enclosure, or to the ground lug internally if I'm using the ENC1618UL enclosure. Inside the enclosure, the other end of the enclosure ground lug connects to the ground lug on the data logger using 14-gauge wire. If there are multiple devices in the enclosure that have ground lugs, do not connect ground lugs together. Instead, run a separate wire from each ground lug to the enclosure ground lug, so that current may take the shortest route to the earth without interacting with other devices. This type of grounding is called a single point ground or a star grounding system. Using a central grounding point minimizes the creation of ground loops and voltage differentials between interconnected equipment. This reduces the risk of ground-related noise, interference, and equipment failure. Enhanced grounding systems may be required when site conditions make it difficult to achieve the goal of 5 to 25 ohms resistance, or less, between a data logger and earth ground. Most current flow in the soil is carried by ions dissolved in the liquid phase of soil water. Current does not travel easily through air, ice, or minerals. Ideally, the grounding system will be in contact with a wet soil that holds water well. I may have difficulty achieving the goal of 5 to 25 ohms resistance in the grounding system if my site has limiting conditions, such as shallow soil, sandy or gravelly soil, dry soil, or frozen soil. My site may also be problematic if there is already current traveling through it from sources such as power lines, pumps, and electric generators. Problem sites may be improved using various methods, such as a longer grounding rod, multiple grounding rods bonded together, soil amendments such as bentonite, or an electrolytic electrode. Generally, a single 10-foot grounding rod is more effective than 2 5-foot rods bonded together, because the longer rod can reach deeper soil layers, which often have lower resistivity. This also provides a lower resistance path to ground, enhancing the grounding system's effectiveness. Also, the longer rod offers more surface area in contact with the soil, reducing overall ground resistance. This larger contact area improves the dissipation of electricity into the earth. A qualified engineer can make recommendations as to what will work best for a particular installation site. In the next video, I'll talk about avoiding ground loops.